To succeed in film, one must see life in art, and art in life, and capture it.
We didn't know what that meant either, so we just tried to make our own Academy Award-winning film with the plastic bag.
But plastic bags aren't as pretty as they seem in the movies. In real life, they aren't toys.
Sweetheart, ready for... What are you doing? You can't play with that. Plastic bag isn't a toy.
And they don't appear to be art either. So in light of the initiatives being taken by major cities against plastic bags, and our personal struggle to film them, we decided to follow the plastic bag.
We followed the plastic bag to the S. Walter Packaging Company in Philadelphia, where Beth and Audrey told us what the family-owned company does.
S. Walter is a master distributor for retail packaging, and that includes paper and plastic. It includes, you know, like Audrey said, plastic bags, paper shopping bags, boxes, tissue, bows, ribbons, and of the sort, anything that wraps a package. And whatever the retailer's initiatives are towards eco-friendly, we can certainly service that need and, you know, mold a packaging that supports their initiative.
S. Walter produces an impressive number of plastic bags each year.
Multi-millions. Mm-hmm. I would have to say more than 50 million bags.
Oh, easy. Yeah, I'm sure.
S. Walter's extensive bag production does not change the fact that it is part of a growing number of manufacturers who are exploring the intersection between profit and environmental concerns.
We are a service industry, you know, we're a service company, so whatever the need is. But we also like to educate along the way that would gear them more towards an eco-friendly package.
Here's one of our recycling bins for plastic bags.
But despite their focus on recycling plastic bags, S. Walter only emphasizes eco-friendly products if they happen to coincide with the goals of the consumers as well.
But I think the focus has been, what is the customer looking to accomplish, rather than us telling them, you need to do this.
With that in mind, we went to the one place that best models the American capacity for consumption, Walmart. According to the Environmental Protection Agency, the United States consumes over 380 billion plastic bags, sacks, and wraps each year. Americans also throw away some 100 billion polyethylene plastic bags annually, which required 12 million barrels of oil to manufacture. However, these statistics do not point to paper as the better option. In fact, paper bags require more energy to manufacture. This could be one reason why 90% of all grocery bags are made from plastic. Unfortunately, less than 1% of these plastic bags are recycled. But of the few that are recycled, what happens to them? Where do they end up?
And one of the answers to that question is TerraCycle, a Trenton-based company that has found a clever solution to the problem of plastic bag waste.
The first bags that we did were the Target bags, and they contacted us. They came to us and said, do you have an idea for a bag? So we got in touch with Newsweek, and we had this whole cover of the front and back of Newsweek, where you rip the cover off, you tape the ends, and you fill it with the Target bags, and then you send it to us, and then we'll give you a coupon to go to the store and actually receive this reusable bag. That's how we basically got started with it.
TerraCycle is a company that takes waste, like a plastic bag that might ordinarily get thrown away, and turns it into brand new products, such as reusable bags, pencil cases, and backpacks. Even though corporations like Walmart, Target, and TerraCycle seem aesthetically and economically varied, they are all interwoven in the life cycle of a plastic bag.
This is kind of the stuff that we turn the regular plastic bags into to make them into the reusable tote bags. They are just better. They're better than the typical virgin plastic. They're stronger. They're made from old material, and immediately they have a positive environmental effect. This is post-industrial waste. All of these rolls have something slightly wrong with it, so what they're forced to do is throw them out. So what we've done is we said give them to us and then we'll turn them into something. Now, what you really got to think of is this is so many bags, individual bags, that they were sent to us by somebody. So just receiving this is very big and it's huge for their carbon impact.
The TerraCycle recycling process is just one way station in the effort to reduce the impact of plastic bag use. By itself, it isn't enough.
But the problem is, of course, that, I don't know, we're 600 billion bags or something like that this year. It's something insane. So, you know, although we are collecting a lot, it's not enough, and other people need to start putting the laws in place to make it so they are legal.
In late 2008, the city of New York began to consider implementing a policy that would charge 5 cents for each plastic bag. We took to the streets of Manhattan to find out how often people use plastic bags.
I rarely use them because I am very much aware of the environment, so I always carry this in my bag.
4 times a week.
Only when I forget my recycle bags. I don't use them very often.
5 per week.
Whenever we go to the market, supermarket, we use the plastic bags.
What? Very often.
More often than we probably should.
Whenever I'm offered them, or when I want to suffocate myself.
We also asked people for their thoughts on how plastic bag usage would be affected if the hypothetical tax were passed.
In a way, I think it'll be also better because if less plastic bags are used, then we have more resources and more instead of recycling, because most of them end up on the street, you know?
I say go for it. Absolutely charge people to use plastic so they'll stop using it.
I think more people would probably use less bags, not so much because of the cost, but probably for the environment.
If you charge the plastic bag like the five cents, they're going to bring the like a paper bag or the like a, you know, the clothes bag for their shopping. I think it's a good idea because in my country, Korea, they also charge the like some money for the plastic bags. Yeah, to conserve the nature.
I think it would make me even more aware than I already am and try to use recyclable bags more often. I think it's a good thing.
I'd probably have to pay 5 cents more for plastic bags then.
Good cut.
The people we talked to seem to suggest that a quick solution to the plastic bag problem is the implementation of new taxes. But there has to be more to the equation than just that. Solving the plastic bag problem requires tackling more than just consumption. It also means we must change our habits and increase our awareness of the impact that our relentless use of plastic bags has on the environment.
Inscribed on every bag is a warning that plastic bags aren't toys and that they should be recycled. But few things remind us that if we don't need a bag, we don't have to use one.
Our hope is that in a few years, there won't be a plastic bag to follow.